Yo, what's up, my brother? What's up, my sister? This is your boy Oscar Ntege again with yet another amazing video. In this particular tutorial today, I'm going to show you an advanced technique on how to change colors of anything in Photoshop. But before we dive into this video, please take a minute, subscribe to this channel, give this video a thumbs up if you love it, and leave comments below and tell me what has resonated with you after you finished watching this video. And let's dive into it. In this particular picture, we are going to change her dress to, I don't know what color we shall choose, but we shall see as we go. We're going to change the color of her dress to another color. This is the simplest way of changing colors from one color to another. But there are certain things, of course, you have to understand when you're going to change color. There is what they call one hue. Then there is the other thing they call saturation. Then there is some other thing called brightness. Let us look into this. So when you double click around this area, let us see this. You see these particular, these H, S, and B. Of course, hue is the name of the color, if I'm to put it in simple terms. I don't know why Photoshop named it hue. Hue is such a complicated word, in my opinion. Hue is the name of the color. Then saturation is the intensity of the color. Let me just show you here. For example, when you look at this green, at this side, this green is very, very, very intense. It is thick. It is very, very, it is the concentrated version of green, which means that green is very saturated. But when we go towards this side, like around here, this green is a bit non-saturated. It is not intense, so it has less saturation. That is the meaning of saturation. And then brightness means how bright the color is, in that if we move from this particular shade of green and transition towards this side, the green becomes lighter. That is the brightness of the color. So these are the values that we basically change when we are using hue, saturation values. Am I making sense, guys? Oh, comment yes in the comments below if I'm making sense. Okay, now let's dive into this. Now, first things first, this is what we're going to do. We are going to first duplicate this layer, of course, just once, and we're going to name this color. And now we're going to choose the color we want to make this dress. So what color should I choose? Let me just come here and just create a new layer. And should we make it, I don't know, what is your favorite color? Let's make it let's make it a color that is totally opposite. Let's make it this particular cyan blue green, this one. Yeah, okay. And then I'll come here and say okay. So I'll get my brush tool and I'll sample this color. Let me just put it like around here, because we're just going to color pick. Oops, let me just use a hard brush, and then just a small dot will be enough for us. So this particular color is the color you want to be on the dress. So how are we going to place it on the dress? We are going to select the dress. Of course, if you have a new version of Photoshop, definitely there is that this particular tool here. You're going to use the object selection tool. It is going to help you select the dress automatically, and we shall refine the mask later. Okay, so what do we do? You just come and you draw a square just all around the part you want to select, just like that. And Photoshop, using artificial intelligence, will definitely make a selection for you. It is that super simple. So the next thing you're going to do, of course, it has selected out certain things that we don't want to be included in the selection. We want also to include that particular part in the selection. So you still come into that tool, and then you just come and you add on that onto the selection by, of course, selecting it and adding it there, you know. Then if you want to subtract certain things off the selection, now we don't want the arm to be part of the selection, so I'll come here into this particular square here. You see this, the next one, which means minus, and I'll just come and just select the hand so that I have it out of the selection. I'll also come around here and also select that, and remove it from the selection. The same applies here, and also remove that from the selection. Also this one, still also here. And yes, now at least we have a rough selection of what we want. So I'm just going to come also and subtract this. I hate doing overly refining and refining. So I'm just going to come here. Since I want to subtract it, I'll just use the lasso tool and click here, and I'll just come and draw all around. Yeah, I don't worry so much about this. I'll just come and refine it in Photoshop later. So this is what we're going to do now. Now the next thing we are going to do, definitely we are just going to come here and create a group. Click onto the group icon. Let me just zoom this out just a little. I'll just zoom this out. So what we are going to do, you're just going to come onto the click onto the color layer and click onto the group, and then you click onto the mask. You may be wondering, why am I putting the selection into a group? I'm putting it into the group because if I'm to apply any effect, I want the effects to be applied on the whole group, not on particular portions of the image. Okay, so here we're going to come here and still with a group selected, and we come here into layer, into adjustment layers, and look for solid color, like that solid color. So remember the color we had selected. If you want, you can just come and click over here and you say okay. Now this is where I want your maximum attention. This is where I want your maximum attention. Hey, focus. Now here, this is what you're going to do. So you come into blending modes. You only have to look at this bottom part. Now these are the three elements we talked about. We talked about hue, we talked about saturation, and we talked about color. So because we don't want to play so much with the saturation and individual portions of the whole image, we are only going to work with the color, just like that. See? And then because when you look at it, we've lost on the highlights of the dress. So what do we do with that? We need the highlights to pop more so that they don't look too flat. So what do? You just come here in the hue, still saturation layer, you get into the levels. Now we are going to put the levels right below the color so that we brighten up the dress a little bit. So let me just come and drag it here. So I'll just come, click onto the levels, into the icon here, and then just drag and brighten up certain parts of the so that the dress gets brighter. Let me darken the shadows a little bit again, just to make it a bit thick and, you know, more believable and real. Yes, so at least we are 90% there. So I think I can undo this. We no longer need that. So the next thing we're going to do, we are just going to begin refining the mask. You know what I mean? So let us come here and begin, get our brush tool. This is our brush tool. I'll reduce the size and of course put in a bit of softness, and then I get click onto the layer mask. You make sure it's the layer mask that is clicked onto, and then we're going to come and begin painting black in certain parts where we don't want the effect, just like that. So I'll just increase the hardness so that the edges are a bit hard, and also reduce the size of the brush, and I just come over the edges here. And then I'll press X on my keyboard in order to invert this. Yeah, so that white gets on top, and then I paint. When you're using layer masks, remember white reveals and black hides, okay? So you just come and paint over here. So we come and refine this. So we come and paint over, refining it. Yeah, I'm not really going to be very accurate in this, but you can always be accurate when you're doing your, your edits of customers. This is something, I'm doing this because I don't want the tutorial to be so long, but I guess this really helps you out. When you're doing it for your customers, of course, you have to be more precise, more accurate, but I'm just showing you what you can do. Now, still the same thing happens. Here you come. Before you get off, before you click away, I want to show you how you can also. Now, when you look at this particular, the reflections of green here really have changed. It is, we're having red reflections over this. I'm going to show you how to change these reflections so that we have more of green reflections over here, okay? So let me just come and refine this a little bit more so that it doesn't look like steel. Here I just come and refine it. So basically you refine it the way you want to refine it. All these you get into the corners and you refine it in you know, so I'm not going to go into these details, but you get the point, right? So what are we going to do? Oh, you're also going to come and rub this away. And let me just try to. Okay. Just come and rub this away. I zoom in so that I get a better refinement. So I come and paint over like that. See how beautiful we are making this image? Man, the goal of most people, I had people complaining about that my tutorials seem to be too long. Truth, I struggled so much when I was a beginner photographer, in that most of the tutorials that were there, there were no tutorials actually that went step by step into explaining these particular things, in that you found it so hard. Most people taught these particular techniques like they were teaching people who had already used Photoshop before and who were I do this for mostly people who are not familiar with an interface, with a Photoshop interface, people who are beginners, who are typical beginners. That's why I do this. I remember how I struggled. So I thought I would do a channel that is really dedicated to people who are not very, very fast learner. Because personally, I'm a slow learner, and I thought I would tone it down into simplest ways. Yeah. So you can always refine it and give it your own shape and the like, but you now get the point. That's how you change a color of anything in Photoshop using advanced techniques. I'll see you in my next tutorial. If you've taken a lot of value from this video, give this video a thumbs up. Of course, in the comments below, tell me what has resonated with you throughout this whole edit. If you want to buy me a cup of coffee, click the first link in the description below. I'll be super, super grateful. And I'll see you in my next video. And adios.